So today in class 12 biology, we'll start with the dihybrid cross. That is the process of cross mating between the two organism with alternative trait of two different characteristics. That is called dihybrid cross. We already studied the monohybrid in a single character. That is the alternative trait of single character. Here actually two different characteristics is called dihybrid cross. That is crosses between yellow round seed, that is capital Y, capital R, capital R. And green wrinkle seed, that is a small y, smaller, smaller. A pea plant, where it is actually dihybrid cross example. Now move on to the cross. If we see the cross, then if we have a cross involve an inheritance of two pairs of contrasting characters, that is a dihybrid, and conducted this experiment by Mendel. He took two varieties of seed, that is yellow color and round appearance, that is capital Y, capital R, capital R. And green color and wrinkle appearance, small y, smaller, smaller. Both belong to pure and parental generation. Now if we see the cross, here also you will see the diagram. That you observe that offspring with capital Y, small y, capital R, smaller, genotype in F1 generation, that is phenotype, all of them were yellow round. That is, actually it is yellow round is the dominant character. In F2 generation, the four alleles were assorted out independently. Inheritance of seed color is independent of seed coat. So during gamete formation, alleles of both yellow and green color of seed coat will be assorted independently. From the shape of seed coat, that is round and wrinkled, as a result, along with the parental combination of gamete, two new combinations will be formed. Two new combinations will be formed also. Here also you will see the diagram in your screen that the crosses are going on in different ways and different varieties also. So capital Y, capital R, small y, smaller, capital Y, smaller, and small y, capital R. These types of gametes will form of offspring in the F2 generation, which is shown in the Punnett square you will see here. In phenotypic ratio, dihybrid cross in F2 generation, dihybrid cross is as yellow round is to yellow wrinkle, is to green round, is to green wrinkle, is to 9, is to 3, is to 3, is to 1. Whereas this distribution of allele in dihybrid cross is explained by the law of independent assortment. Here also you will see the, I will tell you the law which is told by Mendel in independent assortment. So in genotypic ratio also you will see that different gamete formation will be there. That is 1 is to 2 is to 2 is to 4 is to 1 is to 2 is to 1 is to 2 is to 1. So these are the genotypic ratio of dihybrid cross. You will see here also. So we crossed between tall red flower with dwarf white flowers. Then also the F1 generation of all of them were heterozygous, tall red. During gamete formation, the F1 alleles will assorted out independently. The process of combination of gamete formed in F1 generation, you will see here also in your screen. So dihybrid ratio and phenotypic of offspring, F1 generation, tall red is to tall white, is to dwarf red, is to dwarf white, will be 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1. Here also other different combination also you will see here. By this way, actually different process takes place in case of Mendel, this dihybrid cross. Now move on to the Mendel's law of independent assortment. According to Mendel's law of independent assortments, that there are two pairs of contrasting characters, then the distribution of each allelic pair into gametes is independent of the distribution of other pair of alleles. That is, each pair of character may combine with either of other pair. So that is the independent assortment law, and there is two pair of contrasting character, then the distribution of each allelic pair into gamete is independent of the distribution of other pair of alleles. So this is independent assortment law. So today up to that, next we will start with another topic.